organizer for inviting me to talk before such august audience. Professor Banerjee has already paved the way of my talk. He has discussed the Galilean gauge theory, the meaning of Galilean gauge theory. Since it's a new work, I will first give you the references which R.B. has given in a cryptic way, because he was not using projector. So these are the references. As you have already heard that nearly 1.5 years we are doing this problem. In the first paper, we discussed what Professor Banerjee has taught, the gauging of Galilean symmetry, which you have seen that to some extent is different from what different groups do as Galilean gauge theory. They gauge the algebra. But we are gauging the symmetry. So two types of covariant derivatives are coming in. I don't want to go into the discussion whether it's a pure gauge theory or not. That's not the question. It is a way of getting non-relativistic diffeomorphism such that at the flat tangent space limit, you get back the Galilean symmetry. The geometric aspects is to some extent covered by R.B. when he talked of spatial diffeomorphism. But I shall show that this geometric interpretation is far richer. This is what we did in the second reference. In the third reference, what somebody was asking, we have discussed in an elaborate way how to include gauge field in our procedure and how to include the Chan-Simons interaction. There is a lot of, what I should say, confusion in the literature about these points. The fourth one is a kind of review article, which also contains new results. And finally, our student Orpita, he has included the, she has included the scaling symmetry in the mechanism. So that is a way of going to the conformal symmetry. That can be done. I will first give you a glimpse of what has been achieved. The first point I have already covered. The second, it may be to some extent new for some of the audience that Newton's theory of gravity can also be given a geometric formulation. That was done by Kartan way back in 1923, I remember. And various, many stalwarts actually did considerable important work on that. But that was a metric theory. The nature of Galilean space and time, the nature of Galilean space and time actually compelled Kartan to introduce two degenerate metrics. Therefore, the Vielwein approach, which is so smooth in the relativistic case, from Riemann to Riemann-Cartan space, that's why factorizing the metric, that is absent in this form. Therefore, we took the analogy of Poincaré gauge theory. In relativistic case, Poincaré gauge theory is a is another curiosity which gives you the Vielwein construction. In Galilean case, so far we understand, This is a very powerful tool. Another interesting thing that we introduce non-relativistic diffeomorphism by the process of gauging Galilean symmetry, and the structures which we develop actually can obtain even better result. We can show that a non-relativistic spacetime can be equipped with a single non-degenerate metric, but the boost symmetry cannot be accommodated. This you know that Kurapa gravity was formulated on this geometry. Of course, Kurapa came to this conclusion from another way. So our constructions actually show the non-relativistic origin of Kurapa-Lipschitz gravity more clearly, as we may claim. So this is the summary of Galilean gauge theory. This has just been covered. So I am going to the next step. The fields we obtained in the process of gauging Galilean symmetry is renamed. We define theta as sigma 0, 0 and theta psi k as sigma 0 k, and put sigma a 0 to be 0. I think light here. Yeah? Let me just remind that the lower index of sigma, as in the previous topic of only space, but here I designated by alpha, and the upper index is designated by mu. This is the coordinate in the tangent space, and this is the coordinate in the card space. Its inverse lambda has the opposite placement. Here the space coordinates come downstairs and the tangent space coordinates go upstairs. And of course sigma alpha mu lambda mu beta is delta alpha beta. So light. So now you can see that I am including both space and time, and the gauge fields which appeared during the construction of the global derivatives actually take their values in the Galilean algebra. And the method is what I don't think whether you can see it. I choose the wrong color. But point is that phi is replaced by nabla 0 phi and del alpha phi is replaced by nabla a phi. The most general transformation rules are shown in these lines, which we can compactify as this and this. With that I introduce the transformation of sigma 0, 0, which is theta, which you will remember is function of time, but I write it in a notationally covariant way. So we identify sigma alpha mu with the VL bind and lambda mu mu. This is actually typo. Lambda mu alpha will be the inverse VL bind with respect to the non-relativistic space-time manifold. Interestingly, the transformations which we obtained through the gauging of symmetry gives the correct transformation of A mu alpha beta under diffeomorphism and local Galilean transformations. So they can be interpreted as the spin connection. So we have introduced a manifold, we have introduced the structures. Still, we have not introduced metric. Before that, let me tell you that this matrix sigma alpha mu can be obtained, can be used in two different ways. One, the structures or the elements of this matrix can be used to define two degenerate matrix, and we get to Newton-Kartha. Or they can be used to define a non-degenerate 4x4 matrix, and we go to Borathagrad geometry, and we find that to get appropriate transformation, we have to leave boost there. So far as the geometric construction I have shown, that can be branched into these two ways. So I come to Newton-Kartha. Before that, the connection can be defined through these fields. This will be A. See, another type. The spin connection I was telling in the last slide. So the Galvin postulate allows us to define the connection. Remember that B A alpha beta is not antisymmetric. The space part Aij is antisymmetric. But A0 beta is vanishes. That means in the transformation of the time part, this factor will not appear. So using that, we can prove the metric compatibility of this tau mu. I haven't written this tau. I'm sorry. This is the first time I'm giving this talk. So transparencies are not out. See. The Newton-Cartan geometry is specified by two elements. One, a one form tau mu, another a 3x3 degenerate matrix, 4x4 degenerate matrix, H alpha beta.
Change the chalk.
Oh. tau mu. I have defined there. I have defined it in the opposite. Please. This is H mu nu downstairs I have defined. And the contravariant tau mu. This tau mu can be used to generate a tau mu type metric. Both of these are degenerate metrics. The definition from our construction is this. This and this. So one can easily see that H mu nu tau mu is zero. This is one particular aspect of Newton-Cartan algebra. Also tau mu is equal to one. And the degenerate matrix and seen some of the Newton-Cartan algebra which may be done. So the point I want to emphasize is that all these transformations are obtained from our gauging procedure. Show the metricity, metric compatibility of tau mu and H mu nu. The metric compatibility of H mu nu is some extent difficult to show, but we start from the Gell-Mein postulate and shuffle some indices, then interchange indices, adding by to something like the way one get the Christoffel symbol from symmetric tensor in GR. We prove the metricity of H mu nu. So, then we add some more structure. These are the corresponding covariant and contravariant elements. And they satisfy the Newton-Cartan algebra in the invariable. This is an important thing. In Newton-Cartan algebra, Gottfried has proved that if the connection is symmetric, then the connection can be actually expressed in terms of the metric H mu nu and tau mu. From our definition, tau rho nu mu, when symmetrized, gives this expression. After some algebra, we get the Gottfried's formula. And we actually there is an indeterminacy of a two-form K in Gottfried's formula. We find that two-form is related with this A0 mu, these coefficients. Now we propose a single metric. Newton pattern construction is over. Now we propose a single metric, G mu nu, in this way. We find that G00 and Gij go through. But when variation of G0k is obtained, we see that there is an anomalous term. This anomalous term contains the Galilean boost. So, if we drop boost from the list of the Galilean symmetry, then we can appropriately construct a single non-degenerate metric like this. And like what we do in GR, we can do a foliation, ADM foliation. But the point is that in Galilean space and time, there is the unique role of time. So you know that in Newton-Cartan geometry also, the foliation can be done in a unique way. It is a fixed foliation. So difference is that we get a fixed foliation. Borama also considered a fixed foliation. Then we calculate the transformations of the basic fields, the Laplace shift, and the metric on the spatial foliation. And we find that we get Horava's algebra. So non-relativistic origin of the Horava gravity is clear from our calculation. So let me, I think, how much time I have? So, quite a long time. Let me summarize the works we have done. We started with a Galilean symmetric theory. We localized the Galilean symmetry. We obtained the structures from that. We can show that our theory can be used for diffeomorphism on space. Thereby, the important action which is coming in the fractional quantum Hall effect research. There we can eliminate the confusion that was there regarding the introduction of Chan-Simons field, etc. Geometrically, we can show that both Newton-Cartan and Horava geometry are coming of the same origin. And Newton-Cartan, also one important thing I forgot to mention, if I can go back. The definition of the connection. Anyway, you will see that I am not taking any condition on the connection. So, in fact, we can also include torsion in our mechanism. As one knows that torsion, introducing torsion in the process is supposed to be a difficult one. it has been reported that one has to introduce supersymmetry to get torsiony Newton-Cartan geometry. Then there is another work in the literature which shows, says that no, it is not required. Newton-Cartan geometry, in the Newton-Cartan geometry one can introduce torsion just by gauging the algebra. Results are there, so I mentioned that our procedure can give the most general torsion. And we can go to the symmetric connection and get the standard results. We get new results. So, okay, I finish here. And in the special part, AK, AB is taken as a whole and it is anti-symmetric. But only AK, A0 is included. Well, so AK, 0A is 0.
I'm not understanding why.
You understood? Okay. This comes from the difference of space and time in the Newtonian or Galilean picture.
Now see, point is here that these are fields you have introduced to gauge these symmetries. You need only this component. This part is not actually anti-symmetric. So that means basically you put A, zero, A part, to zero by hand, if you want to get that symmetry out of it. There's no principle which directed that. You want this, you are introducing that.
That these fields AK, A0 are getting values in the algebra, and only this many generators.
So the point is that this whole thing I could have given a different name. Then they would not have asked me a question that why 0 is 0. But now they are putting in the same format so that you identify with what we know of the your gauge field. So you can do that provided you identify also A0, A0. So this goes into your thing to get that.
In the it would contain both the parts.
Of course, point I'm going to tell you, you need that part, otherwise you not get that part.
Okay.
So it happens that unlike us, we didn't start Galilean algebra, we started straight away Poincaré algebra. Maybe some people started with supersymmetry algebra, later came to know about Galilean algebra. So the general theory of relativity one was taught straight into it was taught to us from Poincaré algebra. But recent activities where one tries to look into the non-relative limit of GTR. But I first had it, I didn't understand what do I mean by non-relativistic limit of GTR. So, but then when you see that, you try to connect these things.
Is it a reflection of the fact that there is no space-time boost?
Well, there is no space-time boost in the Galilean thing at all, right? But we know that, yeah, that's right.
Time is not affected, but space is affected in boost.
Sorry?
this.
Yeah, space-based part is there. But the space-time part we are saying, time is totally different.
Now, I'm talking, you think of Galilean transformation.
Yeah.
In the transformation of A, there is a VT.
That's the V8 and T, yeah. That part
but
is
in the transformation of T, there is nothing.
That's right. That's the point. It distinguishes time and space.
That is the reason why zero.
Are there any other questions? We will break now for tea and we will come back here.